Our next game of the day, Hoops Fix Pro-Am 2022, will be Team Emerald versus in the black versus Team Sapphire in the red. So for Team Emerald in the black, we have Jessica Bash, number 3, Carlotta. You'll have to excuse my pronunciation. Carlotta de Mergelina Alonso, Mergelina Alonso. I've tried my best there. You've got Janelle Grant, Millie Watkins, Molly Lavin, and MJ Sarkodia Adu. And for Team Sapphire in the red, we have Imogen Yood, Alicia Moore, Batul Khalifa, Kanisha KD White, Evelyn Adebayo, and Fumi Amode, Kimberly Wilkes also. So the starting five for Team Emerald in the black is number 3, Jessica Bash, Carlotta de Mergelina Alonso, number 7, Janelle Grant, number 4, Millie Watkins, number 8, and MJ Sarkodia Adu in number 11, and their subs are number 9, Molly Lavin, and Emily O'Connell, number 10. For Team Sapphire in the red, their starting five are number 9, Alicia Moore, Fumi Amode, number 10, Kanisha White, number 7, Evelyn Adebayo, number 12, Batul Khalifa, number 11. And the subs are Imogen Ude, number 5. Kimberly Wilkes is number 6. 1 minute until the game gets underway. Hoops Fix Pro-Am Summer League 2022. This is the first week. Second game is about to get underway. We have Team Emerald in the black versus Team Sapphire. I'll be calling your game today. My name is Yang, the Obsidian Eagle. Our first game of the day, we saw Team Diamond versus Team Ruby. Team Diamond came up with the goods. They were playing in black. With an all-round good team play, Lauren Christie, Maisie Spinks, and the crew played some good team basketball. Katie Cox was a beast on the boards. Team Ruby had a good shooting. But here we have Emerald and Sapphire. Emerald in the black, Sapphire in red. I'll just go over their starting fives one more time for guys at home. For Team Sapphire in the red, we have Alicia Moore, number 9. Fumi Amode, number 10. Kenesha White, number 7. Evelyn Adebayo, number 12. And Batul Khalifa, number 11. And for Team Emerald in the black, we have Jessica Bash. Excuse my pronunciation, I hope I did that justice. Number 3, Carlotta de Mejolina Alonso. Number 7, Janelle Grant. Number 4, Millie Watkins. Number 8, and MJ Sarkodia Adu. Number 11 for Team Emerald in the black. And we're about to have our jump ball now. Kenesha versus MJ. And red with the spin. Starting off saucy and early, number 10 for the red, Fumi Amode off of the tip. Team Sapphire are up by 2. And we've had some clarification to the rules, so it's pretty straightforward. If you are in the act of shooting within the 3-point line, you will be awarded 1 point if you miss. And 2 points if you, for example, are fouled from the 3-point distance. But you don't make it, you'll get your 2 points. But if you make the 2-point layup, there is no and one. You are awarded with 2 points. And if you make the 3 from distance after being fouled, you'll be awarded by 3 points. There'll be no free throw shooting in the Hoops Fix Pro Ams. Millie Watkins, number 8 for Team Emerald, plays at the Seven Oaks Suns in the WBBL. Comes up with the boards, finds her teammate. Jessica Bash misses that, number 3. Number 4 misses the hook. Kenesha White, number 7, comes up with the boards. finds Evelyn Adebayo, number 12, shoots the baseline jumper, but it's short. Jessica Bash brings the ball up, finds number 7, Carlotta Alonso, finds Chanel Grant, who shoots a 3, and it's good. Kanisha with the step back, and it's good. Early in the offense, goes to her left hand, looks over the left shoulder, and just hits the step back. Millie Watkins sets a mean pick for Jessica Bash, and she shoots a long distance baseline jumper. And we have an early game. Fumi Omode off of the glass, misses. Janelle Grant comes up with the boards, pushes it in transition, holds it up on the wing, looks at a 3, turns it down, then takes it and misses it. Off of the left of the rim, Evelyn Adebayo drives down the right-hand side, in and out dribble, and loses it. Bash comes up with the steal. Off of the turnover by Evelyn, misses Carlotta on the mismatch down low, misses Janelle Grant. Jab cross, Millie Watkins shoots the elbow jumper but misses. Adebayo pushes the ball in transition for Team Sapphire but turns over the ball. MJ Sarkodie Adu tries to bring the ball up in transition, but Millie Watkins plays at the Sevenoaks Suns, had good season last year, came short in 2 of the finals of the WBBL against the London Lions. Watkins for the baseline jumper, it's short, gets the rebound, finds Adu cut into the basket, but she gets fouled. And that's a foul on Red 7. Kanisha White. And we're getting some subs in for Team Sapphire. Number 5, Imogen Ude is coming in for Evelyn Adebayo. Carlotta comes up with a steal. Janelle Grant takes the screen. Round Millie Watkins, but misses the elbow jumper. And the score is 6-4. Imogen Ude with an early three-point attempt, but no good. Janelle Grant gets the boards. Tries to find MJ running the break, but she wasn't paying attention. And Fumi Omode gets the steal, but it's out of bounds when doing that. Black get a sub in, number 10. For Black, for Team Emerald, Emily O'Connell has come in, and we've got some subs for Team Sapphire as well. Alicia Moore and Amode are off, and in come Kimberly Wilkes, number 6. And Evelyn Adebayo back in. 4:52 left to play in the first quarter of the second women's game of the Hoops Fix 2022 Pro-Am. Wilkes has the ball. Shoots a deep 3, but it's long. Number 11 for Black comes up with the boards. Sarkodie Adu and progresses the ball up court. Finds number 10, O'Connell. Drives right, finds a back in the corner for the corner 3 to extend the lead to 9-4. And kind of just a wild take there by number 11 in red. Batul Khalifa. Wilkes gets the boards. Come in and try to make an impact. Finds Kanisha White. Long 2. And it's no good, it's long. The red team there, Sapphire, are good on the boards, but just can't seem to get the takes to stick, really. pick and roll action there. Finds a mismatch, turns over the left shoulder, but airballs it. Janelle Grant. It's good to recognise the mismatch, but couldn't exploit it. Should have really backed her down, taking it to the basket. Finds Kenesha White. Can't get the pass to stick. Wilkes. Batul Khalifa with the three. Short at the basket. Unable to get the rebound. Team Sapphire there. Emerald come up with the boards. Janelle Grant. Number nine goes tween, drives right and picks up the foul. That's Molly Lavin with a tough take to the basket. Actor shooting, 1 point awarded. Millie Watkins is back in. Number eight for Team Emerald. Travel called Batul Khalifa. Fumi Amode and Alicia Moore back in for Team Sapphire. 2 minutes left to play. Score is 10-4. Jessica Bash shoots the long two, but it comes off of the front of the rim. Alicia Moore, number nine for the team in red, pushes the ball, tries to connect with Imogen and picks up a blocking foul just a bit hastily there. O'Connell for the black team, find Jessica Bash, number three. Takes the screen, hesitation dribble, good take with the left hand, but unable to get the layup to stick. MJ with another 3-4 attempt for the team in black, Team Emerald, but it's unable to stick. Imogen Yude finds Alicia Moore, number nine. Amode cuts to the basket. Strong take. She draws the foul, picks up the point for her team. Score is 10-5. Molly Lavin pushes the ball. One on two, gets past Amode, doesn't get the foul. Scores 10-5. Evan Adebayo stops on a mid-range jumper and it's good. Trying to keep her team in the game. Score is now 10-7. O'Connell drives hard left, finds Bash on the corner and shoots it again. And makes it wide open. Great find there by O'Connell. And Evelyn with another 1-on-5 fast break attempt. Just drives right down the heart of the lane and scores the layup. Watkins backing down a defender. Finds Jessica Bash again, number three. O'Connell drives. One left on the clock. Lefty, no good. And at the end of the first quarter, the score is 13-7. 5 point game. I'd say it's quite evenly contested. Evelyn Adebayo, strong takes to the basket, trying to keep her team involved in the game. Sorry, it's a 4 point game. And we're about to get the second quarter underway. Team Emerald We have number 10, Emily O'Connell. Number 9, Molly Lavin. 4, Janelle Grant. 8, Millie Watkins. For Team Emerald, and number 7, Carlotta Alonso. Number 5 for Team Sapphire, Imogen Hughes. Fumi Omode. Evelyn picks up the steal. They run the break, but the pass is no good on the fast break. Sorry, we have number 5, Imogen Hughes, on the court. Fumi Omode, number 10. Batul Khalifa, number 11. Evelyn Adebayo, number 12. And Alicia Moore, number 9, for the team in red. Team Sapphire scores 13-9. 30 seconds gone in the second quarter. Bit of a lazy pass there, but Evelyn recovers it. Shoots the long three, but it's no good. Molly Lavin pushes the break on her own with a nice bounce pass right through the heart of the defense. Finds Janelle Grant, but she can't get the baby hook to stick. Imogen Yu crosses the ball over, turns around, keeps the ball alive. Fumi drives hard to the basket, draws the foul, and they'll be awarded with another point as she was driving to the basket there. Scores 13-10. A nice pass by Imogen Yu to Alicia Moore down low. Finds her on the baseline. Turn around. Another one right over a defender, but it's no good. Molly Lavin pushing the break again. And another almost good pass. Good look. The execution was a bit poor there. Hits her teammate on the head there off of the backboard, but it was a good, we could see what she was trying to do there. Push the ball right down the middle and nails Millie Watkins on the head, but they're still up by 3. Imogen Yude with the ball takes the P&R action from Evelyn Adebayo. Adebayo pops, finds Batul. Ooh, tries to mix it. Getting crafty with the handle and just throws the ball away as she's pressured by Emily O'Connell. And they've just had a sub. Forgot to ask the table, but Emily Wilkes has come straight into the game. Janelle Grant, low block, finds Carlotta Alonso driving to the basket, but Adebayo progresses the ball up, and she's just going to take it. Stops on the midi again, and it's no good. Millie Watkins brings the ball up. Finds Molly Lavin in the corner for a three-point attempt, but it's no good. Emily O'Connell gets the rebound. Watkins finds Lavin, but she's unable to convert. Watkins, little push shot, hits the front of the rim, and Batul Khalifa gets the rebound. Evelyn Adebayo leaks out, kind of lazily throws the ball towards the basket, tries to initiate contact but can't get the basket to stick. Carlotta Alonso, number 7 for the Team Emerald, finds Molly Lavin, left hand drive, easy floater, but it doesn't drop. Omode pushes the ball on her own. Number 10 finds number 9 and scores the basket with some sturdy pivoting and footwork there down low. Alicia Moore. And number 10 tries to respond with an early three-point, but the subs are coming in for Team Kenesha White, coming in for the red team, Sapphire. And number 3 coming in for the black team, that is Jessica Bash. Team Emerald are up by 1 point. with 5:27 left in the second, in the half of the second game of the Hoops Fix Pro-Am 2022. Some ball movement, puts the ball to ground, drives strong to the basket, picks up the foul and gets the point. And it seems like Team Sapphire are just kind of whittling away, picking up some lazy fouls against Team Emerald and willing themselves into the game. The game's now tied with just under five left. The scores are 13-13. Number six, Wilkes, finds Adeboye. Step back for the long two, but it's short. Kenesha White with the tenacious defense there, staying down low and being a nuisance as she's just been checked into the game not too long ago. O'Connell, number 10, finds Bash, number 3, whips it to the corner. Lavin drives, spin move on Adeboye, picks up the foul, takes her right to the basket. And picks up the foul, number 12, Evelyn Adeboye. And remember, ladies and gentlemen at home, if you've just tuned in, shooting fouls that are not scored from two-point range, the teams are awarded with 1 point. And if you shoot a two, or a three-pointer, sorry, and you're fouled, you get 2 points if you don't make it. If you make the basket, there are no free throws. So you're awarded with all 3 points, and if you, for example, are driving to the basket, you score a layup, but you're fouled, you'll just get the 2 points. Adebayo finds Kenesha White down low, tries to put it up with the left. Alicia Moore doesn't come down with it. Drives strong on Emily O'Connell, finds Amode, spins and throws up a hope and a prayer. Sarkodie finds O'Connell, and they run a good fast break, and Lavin makes Team Sapphire pay with the fast break there. We have Carlotta Alonso, Jessica Bash, Emily O'Connell, Molly Lavin, and MJ Sarkodie Adu on the court. Kenesha White shoots the patented step back jumper for two, keeps the team in the game, scores 16-15, but it seems like Emerald are just pushing the break now. And Sarkodie Adu shoots another three from the top, extending the lead. Scores 19-15, with 2.5 left in the half. Kenesha White finds Adu. Oh, over one shoulder, back over with a little bit of a dream shake, but just can't get it to stop, drop. Cannot get it to stick. The subs are coming in. Alicia Moore comes out of the game for Team Sapphire. And Imogen Ude is in. Millie Watkins. Left hand drive. Pushes the floater. Unable to get it to stick. Kisses the top of the backboard on that three. Point attempt. Number three for Emerald, Jessica Bash. Good entry pass, goes over the left shoulder, Janelle Grant, number four. Jessica Bash pushes the floater, misses it. Kenesha White with a nice drive to the basket. Gets a layup to stick. Millie Watkins turns the ball over. Kenesha White pushing again. Misses the opportunity to pass to Amode and gets blocked. Could have had a bit of a better heads up play there from number seven in the red. Oh, a nice entry pass, but couldn't get it to stick. 40 seconds left in the quarter. White down low trying to get some retribution for a last turnover, but gets the ball picked out. Mm-hmm. shoots the three, hits the front of the rim. 15 seconds left. Number six misses the floater. And Sapphire are unable to hold on to the ball. The score is 19-7 with 5 seconds left. And that is the half. We had a good first half there. I'd say it's quite evenly contested. Team Emerald in the slight lead with some good long distance shooting from their number three and their number 11, MJ Sarkodie Adu. Molly Lavin progresses the ball up the court quite well, but Evelyn Adu has been willing and keeping her team in. Alicia Moore has been quite tenacious on the defensive end and getting some tough layups to stick down low. Not necessarily being the tallest player, but playing with a lot of heart and scoring some timely layups. Fumi Omode started the game well. Kenesha White has been making some good shots as well down the stretch in the first half. But Emily O'Connell, Carlotta Alonso have been playing some great defense and pushing the pace of the game quite well for Team Emerald in the black. The score is 19-17. Had a very interesting conversation about
I'm not sure.
And we're back in to the second half. Amode drives. And a great rebound by Alicia Moore. Gets repaid for her efforts. Shoots a long baseline too. It's no good. Back into the second half. Millie Watkins down low. And gets the hook to stick. Goes over her right shoulder. Down low. Extends the lead to four for Team Emerald in the black. On the court, we've got Alicia Moore, number 9, who's got the ball in her hands for Team Red. Nice right-hand drive, but it's no good. Number 10, Femi Amode. 12, Evelyn Adebayo. Number 11, Batul Khalifa. And Kanisha White, number 7. For Team Emerald in the black, we have Emily O'Connell, Jessica Bash, MJ Sarkodie Adu, Janelle Grant, number 4, and Millie Watkins all on the court. Batul Khalifa finds Kanisha White on the wing. Evelyn Adebayo at the top. She's changed her sneakers. Will it help her jumper? It doesn't look like it has today. The score is 21-17. Emily O'Connell finds Millie on the cut. MJ for a three, and it's no good. Rims out. Evelyn Adebayo gets the rebound, pushes the break. Goes tween. Goes straight through the middle. Finds Femi Amode trailing. Right hand drive. And gets nothing from that. Ooh. But sticks with the defense. Finds Evelyn Adebayo. And they get the rebound. Sorry, they get the steal and the layup. Off of the turnover. Ooh. Tries to curl and cross. But no good. Janelle Grant with the rebound, but no good. Janelle Grant with a step back, and it's good. It's a close game here in the Hoops Fix program, the second ladies game. Batul Khalifa goes right by a defender and gets blocked by the help defense by Janelle Grant. It was a good move, went straight past the defender with the nice tween. Ooh, O'Connell with a double cross. Center defender knocked to the shops and back. Number 10, really good there. MJ Sarkodie Adu pushing the break. Emily O'Connell finds Millie Watkins in the corner. Emily O'Connell shoots a long three. And a bit of miscommunication there from Alicia Moore and Femi Amode. Both teams are getting their subs in. Molly Lavin and Carlotta Alonso are in. Wilkes and Imogen Ude are in. It's a mismatch there. Watkins drives right past her and just backs her down and picks up the foul. Score is 23-19, I think it should be. Sorry, 27-19. The mid-range jumper's no good from Amode there. Is it Alicia Moore over dribbling, potentially tries to find the cutter. They fortuitously keep possession of the ball. Amode drives straight to that right hand that she favours so much, but doesn't get anything. Runs straight into the cameraman. Molly Lavin pushing the break and makes a nice fast break layup. And now Team Emerald are starting to pull away in this second half. Kimberly Wilkes trying to break down a defender. Emily O'Connell with some good defense. Active hands. Fumi Omode has the ball at the top. Finds Imogen Yude. Right hand drive. Misses the layup. Molly Lavin again pushing the break. Sees O'Connell. Completely sells the defender. And they push another great fast break. And if I was the team in red, I'd call a timeout myself. But maybe they believe that they can claw back somehow. Kanisha White with a pick and roll at the top there. Alicia Moore finds Fumi Omode. Goes to the right. Misses again. Good drive, but just cannot seem to get anything to stick. Can't find the basket. Molly Lavin finds Emily. And again, just runs straight through the middle of the defense. And finds Amelia Watkins. Kimberly spins, right-hand drive, and gets nothing. Can't keep the ball. Oh, what a pass. Another good pass. And Team Emerald here are really just killing them on the break. Team Sapphire needs to get back and really limit their transition attempts. And another shot by Janelle Grant. Kanisha White finds Evelyn Adebayo, sets the pick. She rejects the pick. Finds Imogen Yude. She shoots the three-pointer. It's short. Carlotta Alonso gets the boards, but it's stripped by number nine. She shoots the three. And they double the rebounder. Batul Khalifa takes the pick. Drives hard right, almost loses the ball, finds Evelyn Adebayo, gets it back with a little pick and roll, kicks it to the corner. Imogen Yude shoots the three, and it's good. Sorry, it's a long two. Emily O'Connell pushes the break fast on her own. Finds Molly Lavin on the corner, finds Jessica Bash for three. O'Connell saves it. Great hustle there. Great entry pass. And Lavin picks up the foul. And the ball movement here by Team Emerald in the black just seems to be a little bit better than Team Sapphire. They're moving the ball, finding the open man and shooting good uncontested shots or picking up fouls. Adebayo progresses the ball up the court. Number nine sets the pick for her. Batul Khalifa finds Kanisha White, turns around, shoots straight away but misses. Ooh, and Adebayo just takes it off her in transition. And scores the layup. And has really been keeping her team in here. In the game here. As best as she can. It's an 11-point game. The three isn't good. But Carlotta gets the rebounds. Not good. Lavin gets the rebound. And sticks with it. And they're just swarming them. I think the difference here is the effort. The team in black, Team Emerald team, a little less tired. Maybe making better substitutions. Better rotations. Playing a bit more efficiently. Batul Khalifa tries a right hand layup on the left hand side, but it's no good. Janelle Grant pushes the ball, stops on the dime, shoots the midi, and airballs it. But Kanisha White just throws the ball away. Costly turnover. Carlotta Alonso with the easy two. And they're just turning the ball over with some tenacious defense and just finding the open man underneath the basket. Adebayo brings the ball up, goes tween, spins, step back, shoots the midi, hits the front of the rim. Emily O'Connell, 9 seconds, turns the ball over. Moore with the ball, finds Kanisha White. 3 seconds left, Adebayo shoots the three, and it's good to keep them somewhat alive as the third quarter ends here in the second game of the Hoops Fix 2022 Pro-Am. a 13-point game. And it's really been the defense of Team Emerald here, turning over the ball, pushing the ball on the break, and just making it difficult for Team Sapphire to find good open shots. Maybe the ball sticking in hands a bit too long. But it's been a good game so far. Second game, one quarter left. I hope you're enjoying at home. This is the Hoops Fix 2022 Pro-Am second ladies game. There'll be a few games later on as well today. We'll have the Glacier Boys versus City of London Academy, Hoop Space versus TVC, Worthing Thunder versus Run and Jump, and Elite Bulldogs versus London United, all underway after this game finishes. And the fourth and final quarter is underway in the second game. And an easy pass. They're just lazy on defense there. She gets a backdoor cut to the basket and picks up the foul, extending the lead. On the court, we have Carlotta Alonso, Janelle Grant, Millie Watkins, Molly Lavin, and Jessica Bash for Team Emerald. And for Team Sapphire, we have Imogen Yude, who was just blocked by Carlotta, Kanisha White, Alicia Moore. Oh, with the Euro and picks up the foul. We have Evelyn Adebayo and Batul Khalifa for Team Sapphire. Alicia Moore brings the ball up for Team Sapphire, who are down by 15. She goes right by her defender and throws it off of the glass, but manages to hustle and get the rebound, steal it off of the defender. Imogen Yu shoots the long baseline jumper, but no good. Molly Lavin on that break once again, stops on the dime, shoots the midi, and it's long. But Janelle Grant gets it back, shoots the three, and it's good from the corner. Janelle Grant has been putting on a shooting clinic today, has made a lot of her open jumpers and some tough contested ones as well. Batul Khalifa shoots the long contested three and completely hits the side of the rim. Carlotta Alonso straight down, finds Molly Lavin, shoots a three, but it's no good. Sapphire turn up with the rebound. Batul Khalifa just manages to keep the ball alive. Evelyn Adebayo puts the ball to ground. Step back for three, and it's no good. And both teams are getting subs in. 11 coming in. MJ Sarkodie Adu, who's also been shooting the ball well, and Emily O'Connell. O'Connell O'Connell finds Millie Watkins on the entry pass. Janelle Grant cut into the basket. Good look. Poorly executed. Alicia Moore with a great pass to Batul, but she can't get it to stick in transition. And that's been an issue here for the team in red. Sapphire, they just can't seem to get things to stick. They have good looks, but maybe they're lacking communication or they're tired and unable to really get things going here. Whereas the team in black are making really good plays. Number three tries to go past a defender with an in and out dribble, but just throws it off the backboard. Fumi Omode, number 10 for the red, pushes the ball up. Finds Imogen Yood wide open, but she drives into two defenders and gets blocked when she had the open shot. A bit upset there, feels like she should have been called for a foul. But I thought the block was clean, personally. What do you think? The clean block. Oh, Alicia Moore just right past the defender and one. Makes it look easy, goes right past the defender with the right hand drive.
11, thank you.
And the score is 45-29. Oh, bit of a miscommunication there. She had the lane, but looks for the three in the corner and just turns the ball over. O'Connell picks up Batul Khalifa, full court, reaches in there, gets away with that one, but it's enough to get Batul to pass the ball. It's no good. MJ leaks for the team in black. Emerald. Jessica backing down. Omode goes past the screen, finds Emily O'Connell on the wing. Emily O'Connell puts the ball to ground. Hard dribble there. Goes left, almost gets away with a walk. But the referees are apt here today at the Hoops Fix Pro-Am. Nothing's getting past their eyes. Alicia Moore, number 9, ball on the wing. She's gone past her defender a few times this quarter already. Finds a cut in Omode, and she just swoops to the basket. And Alicia Moore's really trying to put her team on her back here. Scores 45-31. It's a 14-point game. Millie Watkins of the Seven Oaks Suns finds Janelle Grant. Really easy two-man game. Maybe got away with a moving screen there. Who knows? Just to extend the lead. Ooh, Batul Khalifa with a nice crossover. Goes straight to the basket, but airballs the layup. And great running by MJ. Millie Watkins passed a bit too long. Ooh. She runs straight into the wall. Both teams getting some subs in. Kenesha White and Evelyn Adebayo taking out Omode and Batul Khalifa. It's a 16-point game. Team Emerald comfortably in the lead. Wilkes finds Kenesha White. Goes to her painted in mid-range. But it's no good. Lavin gets the boards again. Pushes it to O'Connell. Finds Jessica Bash on the baseline. And she gets blocked. But they call it a foul. Kenesha finds Wilkes. Wilkes with a deep three, but it's no good. Rims off. Lavin with another board. Nice steal by number 9, who's really come alive in this quarter, but misses the layup as the fatigue settles in. There's 3 minutes, 26 seconds left in the game. And Alicia Moore, unluckily unable to score that layup there in transition after the good defense and the turnover. And just a lazy entrance pass there. Emily O'Connell breaks, leaks, and makes the layup off of the pass by Janelle Grant as the lead is almost ballooning to 20 here. Evelyn with the two. Hits the front of the rim. A bit early in the shot clock. Fumi Omode with the reach there. And it doesn't look like the team black and emerald are going to take their foot off the gas. Shoelaces at the moment. Been a great all-round team performance. Great shooting from Janelle Grant. Emily O'Connell, great defense. Jessica Bash with good long-range shooting. Now a 20-point game. Kimberly Walks progresses the ball up the court. Look at the defense from Emily O'Connell. Just locked in, moving her feet. Carlotta. O'Connell doesn't stop, does she? She drives, takes her time, finds Carlotta Alonso, shoots the two. It's no good. Kenesha White just drives to the basket, but gets blocked by number 11 of Black. Janelle Grant receives the pass and shoots the baseline, and it's good with another one. She can't be stopped here today, shooting lights out from anywhere on the court. Alicia Moore with the ball, picks up a dribble, finds Wilkes. Entry pass into Fumi Omode, in my opinion, gets away with a walk. Uses the right hand after driving left. And Molly Laving, rebound, pushes the break. Goes it alone this time and scores it. Too easy. Far too easy, with under a minute left to play. It kind of feels like Team Sapphire have given up. And, well, Team Emerald are just going for blood, aren't they? Another three-pointer hits the front of the rim. Kenesha White misses the wide open two-pointer as this game is winding down. Molly Lavin pushing the break again, finds Carlotta on the baseline. Oh, with a high tackle there, with a high foul there, almost took her out of the sky as things are getting chippy. I think she must be a little bit upset there. Seconds left in the game. It's a 25-point game. Kenesha manages to cut down the lead. MJ Sarkodio, do number 11. Finds Molly Lavin, who's had a great game, just cleaning up everything on the defensive rebound and then just pushing the ball in transition. Emily O'Connell finds Janelle. Ooh, who gets blocked. Tries to shoot the cheeky. There you have it. 57-34. Team Emerald win this game convincingly with great ball movement, pushing in transition. Great shooting from Janelle Grant. Could barely miss today, shooting three-pointers and a lot of long twos. Became a real trouble for the team down, for Team Sapphire down the stretch. That was a good game. And that is the final women's game of today from Hoops Fix 2022 Pro-Am, and we'll have some men's games underway very shortly.